Hi, I'm Agent Clark Griswold. This is Agent Ted Stryker. We're with the Giants in Action Security Team, Investigative Division. Have you seen this man? His name is Vincent Ludwig. He goes under the name Dr. Raj. If you see him, please call the 1-800 at the bottom of your screen. He's wanted for 7 counts of impersonating a doctor. 1-800-GET-SCUM. Please call.
This is an interesting case. What brings you here today?
We love the 70s.
Yeah. John Travolta is my god, man.
Disco is the only way.
The village people really know how to shake.
YMCA down at the YMCA.
Wake up. Get out of this 70s. It's the 90s. Check out a real band from the 90s. Goats, a favorite band.
I'm William Karp, and I'm here with two members of God's favorite band, Ken Summer and Lee Cohn. Lee, how did the four of you come together?
We had nothing better to do, right? We really wanted to be in a band. It's our senior year. Girls like that.
Ken, what are your plans for playing live within the next, say, month?
Well, right now we're in the works of getting this warehouse deal. We're going to get us and another band, probably Dan Kaiserman's band, which you all know and love. And hopefully, since we have this free PA system, we'll use it wisely and make a great amount of money and it please the crowd, you, our viewers, our fans, the ones we love.
How was your first time playing live?
Well, I was a little bit nervous, obviously, but when I got up there, it was just like all the nervousness went away. And although I forgot some parts and I screwed up every once in a while, I got into it and I had a great time. And it was fun to watch people have fun, you know, like off the stage. I mean, just like to be on stage, and it's a thrill. It gets me off.
How did you guys decide to come up with this band?
Kenny made me.
The great thing about the band is we have a lead singer, I guess, but Ken and Greg have incredible voices, and it's just like the three voices together. It's an added effect.
Ken, man, what are the band's future goals?
Well, the future goals for this year are hopefully to continue playing at school, play at Lyle, play at Deerfield, play at people's parties, play at graduation parties. Finally develop a following, develop enough originals where we could record something, and then hopefully by the end of the year, for my brother's connections, try to play some clubs downtown.
Doc, I don't know. I just don't know.
So what is your problem today?
I'm all stressed out. What do you suggest that I do?
How about taking a vacation? Spring break is coming up.
Well, where should I go?
There are many places you can go. Let's see what the other students are doing on spring break.
The first weekend, I was gonna probably take a nice trip up to Michigan, go to Detroit with my buddy Ryan Goldstein. We might see a Grateful Dead concert up there if we can get tickets. And basically besides that, I'm just going to be in this exciting town of Highland Park, and I'll try to find something to do. At least I won't be in school, so it'll be a good time.
Sounds good. Should be fun.
Well, I'm probably the only senior not going away, somewhere exotic, but because I'm not fortunate enough to have gotten into school already. So I'm going to visit some schools, San Diego State, Cal State Long Beach, and be with my dad out in California. And my dad's a good partier, though. I mean, that's what's key, okay? I mean, I don't need my friends, all right? My dad is a good man, okay?
Well, I have hockey. I have hockey practice, so I'm not gonna be catching the Rays. I'm not going to Mexico or anything. But on days that I don't have hockey, I'm probably just gonna go down to Champaign and party with my sisters at college for a little while. So it should still be fun.
I want to visit the grandma down in California with the family.
Sounds exciting. Maybe I'll come. Bye.
We're going to the Bahamas.
Where are you planning on going for spring break?
Moss Creek.
Moss Creek?
Yeah.
For spring break, my friends and I, we're going down to Florida. We're going to go to Walt Disney World, you know, see the sights, hang out for a week, get tan, have a party down there.
Either I will be playing basketball for Highland Park, which I'll hopefully be doing, or if we unfortunately get eliminated, I will be going to Florida for vacation.
I'm going to Palm Springs with a friend of mine. We're staying in my grandparents' condo, and it's going to be a blast.
Spring break is a time of rebirth when the birds start to sing and the flowers bloom again. And on my spring break, I'm going to become a Hare Krishna and burn lots and lots of incense.
I understand you're having marital problems.
Doctor, I can't stop cheating on my wife.
I have the same problem too. I keep having affairs with all my husband's friends. Would you like to be one of his friends?
See what I mean, Doc? She's a tramp.
Just relax, man. I have a solution. Take a look at the family living wedding, where it's okay to have more than one partner.
Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married.
Hi,
I'm Lee Cohn, and we're here at the Family Living Wedding Reception. And the family living class has just been wed. Is it realistic? Is it love? Is it, what is it? Today we're gonna find out here at the Family Living Wedding Reception.
It's Ryan Goldstein, Giants in Action. I'm here with Lori Armin, Missy Hyde, and Jamie Moss. How does it feel to be married, guys?
It was really good.
I'm very happy.
I'm speechless.
What benefits do you think this class will have for you when you really do get married?
I don't know about when I get married, but maybe with the planning thing and with planning the marriage and everything.
It's kind of realistic.
I don't know about being realistic, but it's fun. I mean, it's a fun class. I don't know about it being that realistic, though.
If you guys were actually going to take a honeymoon and the school is going to finance this event, where do you think you'd go?
Acapulco.
Hawaii.
Australia.
Sounds good to me. It's about all I have questions for these guys, so it's Ryan Goldstein signing off.
Hi, this is Elise Nord, Giants in Action. I'm here with Mark Franklin and Lindsay Cantor, two unhappy people today because they weren't married to the ones that they loved. What are your feelings, Mark?
Well, you know, I am married to Allie Kaplan, a sweet girl, but Lindsay has been, you know, always the one for me, is what it is, because Lindsay is the most beautiful woman I've ever seen in my life, and I saw her in Rumors. I love her.
What are your feelings, Lindsay?
Well, you know, it really broke my heart to not be able to marry Mark, and I understand that, you know, it's not for real, and that as soon as we graduate, we'll be able to get married and do what we really want to do.
It's an institute you can't disparage. Ask your local gentry, and all the sales elementary.
Hi, this is Allison Pilot. I'm here for Giants in Action with Jamie and Rob. They're in family living, and they just got married. I was wondering how you guys chose each other to be married.
Oh, well, it's a long story. See, I guess you could say that fate met up with us one time. We both went to the camp plenty of years ago, and we really didn't know each other until I went and picked up that Hershey Kiss and found that Jamie and I were destined to be together back from our Mukwonago, Wisconsin days 5 years ago.
Will you marry me?
Kenny, I would, but this is a binding contract that we have here in family living, and I'd have to get a divorce first.
You've just been presented with a crisis. What is that?
All of my parents' house has just been broken into and all our gifts have been stolen.
What are you planning to do about that?
I don't know. I'm debating whether we should go on with the wedding or whether we should immediately call the...
Actually, the presents really don't matter right now. We should go off the wedding and enjoy...
What? We need our presents to set up our household.
Yeah, we can just go on with the wedding. Don't worry about the presents. We can afford it with our parents' money.
My parents don't want to pay for the gifts. How about yours?
That's going to be a problem. I was counting on your parents to pay for them. I don't know what we'll do.
Rumor has it that your wife, whose name we're going to protect right now, has been spending some time with some other men in this classroom. Would you like to comment on that?
Well, I mean, I'm kind of disappointed because at the beginning I said I wasn't going to be jealous at all. I mean, she could go with who she wanted to be and be with who she wanted to be. But, I mean, she's taking this a little bit too far. I mean, Jesus. I think she hangs out with her best friend's husband. I mean, I don't know what the deal is.
Ted, I'm sorry to hear that. Let's move to a different line. Let's talk about the celebration we have set up for you and solely you and your wife today. I mean, the school decks out cake, fake champagne, and just a very festive party with a lot of people, and it's all for you and your wife. How do you feel about that?
I think it's the sweetest thing they ever could have done. This is beautiful. I mean, it really is. It brings a tear to the eye.
I'm here with Mrs. Enns at the Family Living Wedding. Mrs. Enns is a teacher of the Family Living class. How exactly did the wedding come about, and what made you think of having a simulated wedding in the Family Living class?
Well, I was not a teacher here 15 years ago when it started, but we felt that students, from what I understand, we felt students could better understand some of the responsibilities, some of the decision making, and some of the adjustments that have to be made within a successful marriage by having a simulation rather than just studying about it from the textbook.
Along with the weddings, what else do you do during the course of the semester during the family living class?
Well, first off, starting right away next week, students will be given a budget, a realistic figure, a salary that the average college graduate would be making. This comes as a shock to many of the students, and they have to develop a budget from that, living off of that income rather than gifts from parents and so forth.
Just relax. You must try and relax.
I'm claustrophobic, and Highland Park is thinking of having a closed campus, shutting all the students in.
Come
Calm down. It will probably stay open. And besides, Deerfield has a closed campus, and most of the students like it there.
Really?
Yes. Let's go to the Highland Park High School and Deerfield to hear both sides of the issue.
This is Steve Goldsmith reporting for Giants in Action. Today we're discussing the closed campus issue.
I'm standing here with Senior Mike Ampson discussing the open versus closed campus decision that's going to be rendered in the next few weeks. Mike, how do you feel about the issue?
Well, basically, I think that I'd like to say that open campus should be allowed, but I'll have to go for closed campus because I know a lot of people that go home and do drugs, drink, come back to class ripped or stoned, and I got to be in class with those people. And, you know, I just don't like being in class with people that are under the influence of alcohol and drugs, and many of them sign the athletic code.
Hi, I'm Vicki Schaefer, and I'm here with Bobby and David. They're both freshmen. How do you guys feel about open-closed campus?
Well, I think that if it's open, then people can spend more quality time with their families if they can go home. That's what I feel personally.
Mark, the decision is going to be rendered in the next few weeks. What do you have to say about the issue?
Well, basically, Rich, I really hope that they close this campus because I know that in my 3.5 years here, there's a severe problem with people going off campus and taking part in illegal activities. Plus, I won't be here for it, so I hope they lock all these little buttheads in here so I don't have to sit here and watch it.
What do you think about the closed campus?
You know, I was basically thinking about it, and I think, you know, who are we kidding allowing the future leaders of America to go to Subway, Michael's, McDonald's? I say stick with cafeteria food all the way. Closed campus for me, it's my choice.
Brian, how do you feel about the issue?
I think that the campus should be open at all times so we can get some good edible food because cafeteria food sucks.
Now, the issues come up that maybe people are going home at lunch and using drugs, using alcohol. Mike, how do you feel about that aspect of the issue?
Well, that may be true, but it's better that they have open campus so at least they don't have to ditch class and get in trouble and leave school. And, I mean, if they're going to do it, they're going to do it no matter what.
Hi, this is Allison Pilot for Giants in Action here with Sean. Sean, can you please tell me what you think about having a closed campus at Deerfield?
Well, it's sort of like this. Like you're in a zoo. We're like caged animals. We gotta breathe. We gotta roam the area. We're just like condensed. Everyone just like stays in one place. We gotta get out of school. It's to go crazy 9 periods a day.
Todd, if you had a choice between open and closed campus, what would you have and why?
Well, I think I'd definitely choose the closed campus because the open campus provides a wonderful opportunity for rapscallions and hooligans to go home and abuse drugs and alcohol, return to school, and disrupt the school environment, making it difficult for students to acquire the education they desire in our 113 school program.
Well, I think I'd like an open campus personally. I just feel that reasons. I think that we're responsible enough being in high school as to not go off on some sort of criminal tangent as what most closed campus administrators believe we're going to do. There's not too much to do around here to get in trouble anyway. I mean, we're just going to go for lunch or something like that. It's not like we're going to be going off running wild.
Hi, this is Elise Norchines, and actually I'm here with Nicole Black, a former student of Highland Park High School. Nicole, how do you feel that you've experienced both open and closed campus? Which do you like better?
I like closed campus because it seems that everyone's more together and nobody leaves every period, and I don't know.
And what do you feel is better for the students?
I think closed campus is better. The only time open campus is better is for lunch, which would be nice to go out to lunch once in a while.
Seth, how do you feel about closed campus at your school?
Well, I think if it's good enough for our friends over the other side of District 113, the great Giants of Highland Park, then it's good enough for Deerfield.
I still hate my life.
My life is still so pathetic.
Why are you back now?
We have a problem.
Well, how was the winter formal?
It was fun, but when we got there, we realized we didn't know how to dance.
We were so pathetic.
Don't worry. I have a solution. Let's look at the dance show, and you can learn how to dance.
I'm standing here with Lori Armin and Lindsay Samuelson, two seniors in the 1992 dance show. Lori, tell me a little bit about the dance show.
Well, it's a combination of modern, jazz, ballet, jammer, and
all different kinds of dancing.
Lindsay, what will you be participating in during the dance show?
Well, I'm in four dances, and Boy Girl is something that I choreographed with three other people, and basically, I mean...
And who's your partner for that?
Ryan Goldstein, and he's really great.
He's a sophomore, isn't he?
He is a sophomore.
And you're a senior. Richie Keefe for Giants in Action.
I'm here for Giants in Action with Ryan Goldstein and Richie Keene. What's your part in the dance show?
Well, basically, I'm in the Guy Girl this year, and I'm in the front, so it's been hard learning the dance, but I've caught on pretty well, you know, from the training I've had, and it should be good. You should come see it.
Richie?
Same thing. Guy Girl, I had a solo, a ballet number with Amy Maines, but they cut it due to the fact that I wouldn't wear tights.
How did you two get involved with this?
Well, basically, I didn't roll, Ryan. Me and Ryan used to do some dancing with the Club MTV dancers. Me, Ryan, Jeff Finger, a bunch of us, we used to fly to New York once a month, and we were spotted on there by Lindsay Samson and Allie Shulman, who
kind of flew us back here. We set up a program, signed a few quick contracts, got everything underway. Agents aren't the base, you know, we're having fun dancing. So, I mean, it should be a good turnout to show. Tickets aren't that much. Come see us. Yeah.
Choreographed anything before?
Yes, I have. I began a couple years ago at my ballet studio, and I did an anti-drug piece, which was commissioned by a number of schools, and that was exciting, so I decided to go on with choreography, and I did stunts for 2 years. This is my third year of dance club, and I've done other things at my ballet studio.
And what music are you using for your dance this year?
It's New Age, and I chose it because when I heard it, it just evoked all these neat images in my head, so I liked it, and that's why I chose it.
What message are you trying to convey with this piece?
This piece is about the balance of nature and humanity, and I'm not so sure the audience is going to get that, but we'll try. It's African dance is very into the ground, and American dance is more up, so I'm combining it all, and I have a lot of motions that are towards the sky and a lot that are real into the ground.
Today,
me and my friend, we're very hungry. We like chicken.
So what's the dilemma?
Why, the Colonel's KFC closed down 5 months ago.
That's a foul problem. What about Chicken Charlie's?
Do they have chicken?
Yeah, of course. Let's go and take a look at Chicken Charlie's.
At the brand new Chicken Charlie restaurant. Why do you think this restaurant will be successful when so many restaurants have failed in the past? Do you think Chicken Charlie's will be a huge success?
Oh, it already is a huge success. I think what Chicken Charlie's did was to combine all the restaurants of the North Shore into one. It has Love's in it, it has Michael's in it, it has Stash's in it, it has Claim Company in it, and everyone's sick of Michael's, and everyone's sick of Claim Company, and it just combined them all into one, and it's all healthy, and I think that's what people are looking for.
Great, thanks a lot.
How do you like that toy you got with your kids' meal?
Good.
Good?
Is it fun?
Yeah.
That's good. What's this plate you have here at Chicken Charlie's?
This is an unburger. It's a chicken breast, two slices of bread, some coleslaw, a fork, a knife, and some Coke.
Hi, I'm Kevin.
Well, Doc, I've cut back on makeup a little.
Good. Now about those dresses.
Hold everything! Are you Dr. Raj?
Jess, is there a problem?
I think so. I'm Agent Clark Griswold. This is Agent Ted Stryker. You're under arrest for impersonating a psychologist. Let's go. Move it.
Let's go, Bell. With us.
Come on.
Look right me. Tight jeans and long blonde hair, but not a care in the world. What happened to the attitude they used to have at school? What happened to the attitude where you broke all the
Allison, are you going to the girls' softball game this weekend?
We have a softball team?
Yeah.
I never knew that.
Doesn't anyone have any pride at this school?
Are you kidding?
I'm sure there's some pride somewhere.
Let's try and find some giant pride.
Where'd he disappear to?
I guess he went to go find some giant pride.
This is Richie Keene standing live with Lee Cohen and William Karp. We're here in Highland Park High School looking for giant pride. We're not sure where it comes from. We know it's here. We know it's strong. The question is, where does giant pride come from? We're going to come talk to students. We're going to talk to teachers. We're going to look in different rooms, different classrooms. We're going to go to the cafeteria. We're going to go to the nurse's office. We're going to be everywhere looking for giant pride today, right now, right here. Let's go. Excuse me. Before you do the interview, do you have any idea where giant pride comes from?
No idea where it comes from. Don't ask me.
You have no idea. It's alive. It's strong. We know there is giant pride in the school. You have no idea where it comes from. Try the men's room. Here at the men's room, we're live. We're going in. Let's go. Here we are. We're opening the door to the men's room. Here, Richie Keene, Lee Cohen, William Karp. We're walking through. I see we have a specimen. Let's keep it down. Excuse me, sir. I hate to interrupt you at this time. Could you tell me, where does giant pride come from?
It comes from right here, baby.
Thank you very much. We have a mirror. We have a mirror. This is who we are. This is Lee Cohen, our light person, William Karp on camera, and of course, I'm Rich Keene on microphones. Excuse me, ma'am. Do you have any idea where giant pride comes from?
Giant what?
Pride.
Never heard of.
Okay, thank you very much.
Nothing.
You don't know nothing?
No.
No habla inglés? Russ, we'd just like to talk to you about giant pride.
Giant pride. This guy, you have him doing an interview. What does he have to do with you? Is he associated in any way whatsoever with you guys?
I'm it.
This guy, why is him? There's nothing more despicable than this creature. You know, if it were up to me, there'd be absolutely nothing, no way whatsoever that would enable you guys to come into my classroom.
I don't know about giant pride. You know where giant pride is. You know where giant pride comes from. We're on Giants in Action, an investigative crew. We'd like to know where giant pride comes from. Please talk to us.
Giant pride comes from deep down in your soul. You are either born with it when you come out of your mommy, when you're born in Highland Park Hospital, or you transfer from another school.
Where does giant pride come from?
Homegrown marijuana.
Maybe we should contact Parkside. We're standing down here in the boiler room, the basement, the pit of despair of Highland Park, so to speak. We're looking for giant pride. As you can see, there's some sort of tubing, some sort of tunnels down here, sort of maybe there's something flowing in these tubes helping giant pride's energy come. We're looking for giant pride. Anything we could... Oh, my God. Excuse me, sir. What are you doing down here?
I've stuck for here for 8 years.
For 8 years? What did you come down here 8 years ago to do? What were you doing down here?
I was looking for Giant Pride.
Giant Pride. You're looking for... Let's go. We're out of here. Let's go. Now, we're out of here. I ain't getting stuck down here for no 8 years. Let's go.
This is what you should do with those students who simply don't listen. These ears, do you realize that when I had him first semester, he had 3 ears? He's down to 2?
This is Giants in Action, investigative crew on the road. Come on, we're going to go to talk to some of the people in the town of Highland Park. We're going to get into our Giants in Action mobile.
They might be giants.
I'm standing here with Joe Costanza of formal wear fame. Joe, do you know where Giant Pride comes from?
Oh, it comes from dressing well, looking good, and that's it.
Thank you, Joe.
They might be giants. They might be rain. They might be frying up a stock of weed.
And where does Giant Pride come from?
Are you going to get a haircut or what, Rich?
Come on, Jim. Where does Giant Pride come from?
Don't you know? It's in the style.
Now, Ron, I don't want to publicly embarrass you, but didn't I ask you not to come into class? Didn't I say that maybe, just maybe, if you did your homework, I would agree, I would consent to an interview with you on Giants in Action?
I'm sorry.
Todd, where does Giant Pride come from?
I'll tell you, Rich, Giant Pride is something that comes from deep inside. It's kind of when you see that Deerfield red, you're a little upset, like...
So where does Giant Pride come from?
Giant Pride comes from the energy inside the HPHS Giant Bat Belt.
Comes from funky camera angles.
Well, what the three of us discovered on our Giants in Action investigative crew mission was that Giant Pride is different for every person. Every individual has their own Giant Pride, and it starts inside you.
Incidentally, thanks for coming in.
Lo que acaban de ver es un programa ideado, grabado, editado y producido en Chicago, Estados Unidos, por estudiantes de la materia de televisión en el College de Highland Park del mismo lugar. Entre uno de los 15 seleccionados en una clase de 60 alumnos figuró Roger Serrate Landívar como único estudiante extranjero. En esa ocasión se filmaron 8 distintos shows en un espacio de 6 meses y medio, que por la misma política de esa institución era imposible la reproducción de estos, a menos de conseguir una orden imposible de obtener. Por esta manera, gracias al servicio de inteligencia boliviana, en los Estados Unidos se logró extraer y copiar el álbum 1 y parte del segundo, que por motivo de miedo no fue este terminado de copiar. Como se apreció en su pantalla, que el mencionado video fue hecho en momentos en que el artista boliviano no tenía el suficiente grado de conocimientos en el idioma inglés. Por esto que habrán podido observar algunas lagunas en este tema. Agradeciendo su comprensión y felicitando a este joven artista, saluda Empresas Serrate Landívar.